Hi, Symphonia, and happy Theory Thursday. We are going to be returning to our regular Theory Thursdays every week, just like we usually do in class. You're going to see on Google Classroom that there is already an assignment posted. What I would recommend is opening one tab with Theory Thursday in it and one tab with this video so you can follow along and do your work as this video goes. Did was on Composers 101. We talked about Vivaldi, Bach, Haydn, Beethoven, and Dvorak. Today we're going to talk about some classic composers as well as some modern composers, so I'm really excited. Our first composer that we're going to talk about today is actually Tchaikovsky. Probably all of you have already heard of Tchaikovsky before, but we're going to dive in a little bit more. So Tchaikovsky was born in Viatka, Russia in 1840, and he lived all the way until 1893. You're going to see on your Google Classroom assignment that I want you to figure out how long he was actually alive. So 1840 to 1893 in Viatka, Russia. We are going to listen to some Tchaikovsky, of course, so that you guys can form your own opinion. But some significant facts about Tchaikovsky. He was known for these sweeping emotional melodies, often in the piano or in the violin. And you might know him from writing music for Swan Lake, which is a ballet. And also for the Nutcracker, which we all know of and think of during the holidays. He did compose for all instruments, but he made a lot of his money off of ballets at the time. He also wrote one of the most significant violin concertos, which is a piece for solo violin, and it's still regarded as one of the best violin concertos even today. So we're going to take some time and listen to a little bit of Tchaikovsky. You may want to reverse this video so that you can hear some significant facts. Make sure you write down at least two. Okay, let's go ahead and listen to Tchaikovsky. Did you like the music? Can you find some ways to describe it? Hopefully using musical terms or just telling me what you think you heard. Next up, we're going to be talking about Edvard Grieg, who is one of my very favorite composers. He's just so much fun to listen to. So Edvard Grieg was born in 1843 in Bergen, Norway. He lived all the way until 1907. So take a little bit of time and figure out how long he actually lived, 1843 to 1907. So Grieg is known for piano concertos and this really unique, spooky kind of sound. This is why I like him so much, because when I listen to his music, it always reminds me of like Halloween. The chords are always a little bit scary. You might not know this particular phrase. Peer Gynt is a work that he composed, but you probably will know some of the songs in it, like In the Hall of the Mountain King or Morning from Peer Gynt. You may also know him from some of his popular piano concertos. He did grow up playing the piano. So we're going to take a little bit of time and listen to Edvard Grieg. And just take a listen and let me know what you think. If you can describe it using a couple of sentences and then tell me. I just love Edvard Grieg, so I hope that you guys love that too. As always, you can go on YouTube and just search that composer if you want to listen to more, or on Spotify, Apple Music, whatever. Next up, we're going to be talking about a modern composer who is actually still alive. Her name is Meredith Monk, and she is a very interesting person. I think you guys are going to really enjoy her music. So Meredith Monk was born in 1942, and she is still alive today. So figure that out if you can think 1942 to 2020. How old is Meredith Monk right now? She was born in New York City and stayed in the New York area for most of her life. She is actually a singer, so she uses her voice primarily, and she mostly composes her voice as well. She's regarded as one of the most groundbreaking and inventive composers of our time. Usually when we think of voice, we think of like really beautiful singing and melody and harmony. Meredith Monk actually thought of the voice a lot differently and still does today, where she turned it into a percussive instrument. So it's people making all different sounds with their voice that can create a really unique sound for a piece that we just can't get from instruments. She's often called the magician of voice because she's really turned voice into something else. And she attended Sarah Lawrence College in New York City. So we're gonna listen to a Meredith Monk piece, and if you could describe what you're hearing in at least two sentences, and then. Still alive. His name is Mason Bates, and he was born in 1977. So go off ahead and figure out how old Mason Bates is now if he was born in 1977. He was born in Richmond, Virginia, which is again in the United States, and he actually lived on a farm for most of his life, which maybe gave a little bit of insight into why he composes the way that he does. He graduated from University of California, Berkeley, with a PhD in composition. So what that means is he's earned the highest level of education for writing music that's possible. There are plenty of PhDs in composition in the world, but it's a really high honor and one that you have to work really hard for about 10 years in college to earn that PhD, and that means he's a doctor of music. He did win a Grammy in 2016, so just a couple years ago, for Best Opera that he actually wrote. And Mason Bates is usually known for using like weird instruments. He takes a lot of machines and turns them into musical instruments. So we're going to listen to a little bit of Mason Bates. And if you could go ahead and describe what you're hearing in a couple of sentences, and then let me know if you like it. Bye, guys. First online Theory Thursday. As always, you guys can reach out to me via email, in Google Classroom, or leave a comment in the comments box here. I hope that everyone is watching the YouTube videos, and of course, go to that Excel file that I posted and sign up for a private one-on-one lesson where we can video chat and also play instruments together. Please make sure that you complete this Google Classroom assignment. You do have a few days to do it, but don't wait on it too long and do submit it so that I can grade it. Okay? Hope you guys are doing well.